sat my beer and but didn't watch the TV because next to the TV on the wall was a toggle switch. One side said TV, the other side said adult. I just flipped to the adult side and I didn't want to touch it, so there wasn't any TV watching that night. But there was a restaurant, a recently built restaurant, for some reason this abandoned area called the Ranch Room. Someone over there. New inside. I don't know why someone planned to put a restaurant there. I don't know why. It was clean. Two young, fresh bartenders. So I sat at the bar. There was one other guy in there who had three empty tall boys in front of him. Each one different. He was testing out different Bush, Coors, something else, a Tapas. And, the bartender brought him over, another one, without clearing the other three, just left him there. Said, you want this, right? He goes, yeah. Work is stressful, that's why I come in here. Then he looked at me and said, I can tell you're an artist. I'm an artist too. I thought, oh, yeah, that's right. When I travel, I usually wear overalls because they're comfortable. It's like a big jumper. Windows down, my hair is in braids. I brought a beard too. It looks like an LSD milkmaid vision. Maybe that's what he meant, but he can tell I was an artist. I don't know. He didn't look like an artist to me. He looked like a guy who explodes things in his backyard. Which I found out later he does, because he apologized to somebody in the bar about it. Sorry about my yard over there. Exploded that thing in there. But he said, I was looking at the menu, and he said, food's good here, you get a lot, and it's good, and it's cheap. And he held this plate, this platter with nachos, there was something dark on top of it. He said, $7, brisket nachos. I only eat a little bit of it, a third, you want the rest? I said, no, he says some dental work done, I can't eat that. And the bartenders were talking to him that their boyfriends or husbands were out of work. And this guy said, oh, I've seen work around here. A lot of construction. He pulled his phone, started pecking around. Yeah, this company, I've seen them. They do what's called, and he looked at me and said, what's it called? Heavy equipment work? I don't know. That might be a genre. I'm not sure. And one of the bartenders said, give me that number, I'm gonna write it down right now. And she wrote it on her ordering pad. She said, I'm gonna call them right now. And it was 7:30 at night. She was gonna call with music playing in a bar after hours to a company to arrange an interview for her boyfriend. That's devotion. Or desperation. Both start with the same letters. It's hard to tell. Then Frank started getting into some weird subjects and I had to leave.
Soon I'll be home.
take some man's life. One of them was mine. Hand me that little wall and picture. Oh, the lights on the street. When I'd walk to you at night, we're so blind and lit. Therefore, a little flame is mine and yours, and that torch in the air. Kissed it away as you packed up your load. There was one last look, and then you all broke free. Now the ditches are flooded over the back road. And then this stretch of 99, it takes so many lives. One of them was mine. Spend too young to I just stumble on tell. Oh, picture you. We just won't let down. Even closing your eyes, you can't let it go. Surrounded inside, leave it alone. Don't get it back. Undoing the things you can't explain. Whatever it is you dream, that you buried away. It seems like you're there as someone removed and left in their place with nothing to do. Bound to the switch, railing again at the thought of the fight for a well-earned descent. Undeserved at the time. You've shown, oh.